I need to understand the makeup and the structure of the team that is making the decision. What does that look like? Is there community participation, parental participation? Who is on this team that's making the decisions as to where, whether or not what schools will be assigned where?
So, broadly speaking, we have Superintendent White, we have Ramsey Green, and myself, Patrick Dobard, Delano Ford, who's over here, Dr. Amy Westbrook, who's over here. That makes up our core leadership team, but we also have others, so you see on staff here, Gabriel Bourdave, Adam Hoff. I mean, there's a number of us on the team that work to actually process these community meetings, which we've put out the proposed siting analysis with the criteria. We're taking feedback both on the criteria and feedback on the actual assignment.
So I'll go back to my question. Where can I find a list of the names of the participants who will be making these life-changing decisions in less than 60 days? Because if they don't include parents, clergy, parents. We always hear about parental involvement, but I have issues with parents being involved just at one level. If we're going to be involved, we need to be involved throughout the entire process, not just brought in for window dressing, and then when the real decisions are made in some back room, there's not one parent that's sitting in that room, okay? So I need to know, where can I find the list?
We have a list of parents we meet with at a parent meeting that Superintendent White hosts. We're going to be taking names here. I don't think we're going to publicize the names here, but there is no parent list on our team. So, thank you.
These guys are going to make the decision.
We're going to take
white dudes from out of town are going to make the decision.
I fully admit we are merely a filter of getting all of this information together.
Five people that are on this team, is one of them?
Find out where they all used to work.
I'm just trying to understand this.
All I'm saying is it's our obligation as government to take everybody's input, and that's what we're doing. And then we have to come to a conclusion of a public policy decision.
Okay, so I'm going on record and telling you, if you're simply a recorder, a filter, you're gathering information, shame on you that you're planning for the future of this school system going forward, but you did not see enough value in the people whose lives that are going to be impacted to include them in the decision-making process. This is window dressing. We've gone through hundreds of these meetings, but when it comes down to the decision where the rubber meets the road, you can't tell me that it's one parent sitting on that team. It's five of you. You have children. They're not in school. I don't know what your situation is, but we are here fighting for the future of our children. But you can't answer me, because if you only had five and you had one parent, you would know their name. So that means that there's none. So that's a broken process.
We're taking the input now. Sir.